Still yet another way to install Windows 11 with only a local account. Hi everyone, Leo Notenboom here for askleo.com. Once again, to be clear, I'm not an AI. And of course, be sure to visit the written article, also not written by AI, that accompanies this video. It's at askleo.com/185914. All right. Microsoft has removed bunches of different workarounds that people have discovered that allowed them to install Windows 11 without using a Microsoft account. Their recent justification claimed that a change was to avoid missing important parts of the setup process. Yeah, important for who? The technique I'm about to describe is really simple, but it's also time-consuming. And so far, my results show that it works. I've done it a few times. The resulting installation of Windows 11 Home has only a local account. The trick, if you want to call it that, is that we actually start a little further back than you might imagine. I call it the Windows 11 local account two-step. Step number one, install Windows 10 from scratch with only a local account. Here we are in the Windows 10 setup program. I have booted from the Windows 10 installation media, and I'm going to go through the process of installing Windows 10. Now, the trick that worked with Windows 10 is the trick that I'm going to use right now. This machine is not connected to the internet. I've unplugged its cable, so to speak. So let's go through this. We'll hit next. We'll hit install now. If you have an installation key, if you've got a product key for Windows 10, enter it now. If you don't, that's fine. You'll be able to enter a product key later. If you enter a product key here in Windows 10 and successfully install Windows 10, then eventually you will end up with a fully activated Windows 11 as well. For now, I don't have a product key. We're just going to go ahead and move ahead. This is going to be Windows 10 Home. I'm using Windows 10 Home specifically because I have heard that there are no known workarounds for Windows 11 Home local accounts. So this will get us one with Windows 11 Home. Hit next. Accept all those license terms. We're going to do a custom. I'm actually deleting all of the partitions on this machine. It's something, a machine that I've been playing with, of course, as I run these experiments. So what we have here is a completely empty hard drive with no partitions on it. Windows 10 is going to go ahead and set up whatever partitions it wants as part of this process. And off it goes. It's copying things to this empty hard disk. Okay, a fair amount of time and a couple of reboots later, we are once again continuing the Windows 10 setup process. Yes, I'm in the United States. Yes, that's the right keyboard. I don't need to add another keyboard. And now we come to this, let's connect you to a network. Let's not. Instead, we'll click on I don't have internet. Now we have this opportunity to say continue with limited setup, which again is exactly what we want. It's going to ask us who's going to use this PC. This is setting up the local account. So I'm going to type in L-E-O-N, which is what I use for local accounts on my machine. That's the username for this local account. We'll click on next. We'll enter a password. We'll enter the password again. Security questions. Again, up to you. It is going to require them. I don't use security questions for this, but if there's the possibility that you might need to recover a forgotten password, be sure to make these make sense to you. Click on next. The whole privacy thing is completely up to you once again. I'm just going to accept the defaults for our little example here. We are not going to accept Cortana. I remember Cortana. And now we're here at this final stage of Windows 10 setup. And here we are in Windows 10 with, of course, a local account. If I take a look here at settings, and you can see that it says Leon local account. That's the account we created. All righty. This is not what we wanted, is it? We want Windows 11, not Windows 10. Here's the next step. Replace the Windows 10 installation media with Windows 11 installation media. Indeed, there it is on my D drive on this machine. I'm going to open the folder to view files, but the thing we're going to do is run the setup program. So we're in Windows 10. We've done nothing but set up Windows 10 with a local account. Now we're going to run the Windows 11 setup program in order to upgrade our Windows 10 to Windows 11. Install Windows 11. That is exactly what we want to do. And remember, we have not yet connected to the internet either. The Ethernet cable on this machine is unplugged. That's perfect. Click on Next, and we'll proceed with the Windows 11 upgrade process. And as said, again, as always with the Windows installation, this might take a while. I will save you from having to spend that time. And there we are. We are in Windows 11. Note that I am signing in with my local account. And of course, it's going to go through the quote-unquote out-of-box experience, OOBE, asking us a few things, getting the system ready for us. And indeed, here we are in Windows 11. Now, you'll notice that a lot of these icons aren't coming up. That's because we still haven't connected to the internet. I'm not going to do that just yet. What I am going to do is fire up the settings app so we can once again see that we are my local account, administrator capable account. What have we got? What we did was we installed Windows 10 with a local account and we upgraded it to Windows 11, which kept that local account. It did not force us to create a Microsoft account. The installation of Windows 11 that we're looking at right now is an installation with only a local account. Now, at this point, there are probably three things you want to do. One, yeah, it's probably about time to connect to the internet. The machine's not going to be particularly useful until we do, but the idea, of course, is that by not having connected to the internet, we prevented a number of opportunities for Windows to update itself, but also for Windows to, quote-unquote, force us to install with a non-local account or a Microsoft account. Second, it did not have an opportunity to update along the way. So you probably do want to go ahead and connect to the internet and then immediately go to Windows Update and then just check for updates over and over again until there are no more updates available. It's going to take a little while because there's probably a number of updates that normally would have been part of the setup process, but unfortunately are not, so we now have to take them all at once. And finally, I want to say, be careful. You don't have a Microsoft account on this machine. However, Windows will encourage you to sign in with a Microsoft account multiple times and in multiple different ways. Now, assuming you want this computer to have nothing to do with a Microsoft account, resist all those requests. Signing into any service with a Microsoft account, even once, can have ripple effects that go far beyond whatever service it is you think you're signing into, particularly if you didn't read the fine print. I assume you understand what you're missing without a Microsoft account. Things like backing up BitLocker recovery keys, using cloud storage, and managing other service and features become your direct responsibility. And I absolutely understand that for many people, avoiding those features from Microsoft is exactly the point. But the bottom line here is that this is a very, very simple process. Install Windows 10 with a local account and upgrade it to Windows 11. For now, it works, at least until Microsoft puts up another roadblock. For updates, for comments, for links related to this topic and more, visit askleo.com/ 1-855-914. I'm Leo Notenboom. This is AskLeo.com. Thanks for watching.